Before we get into today's Rams and Cardinals preview, I want you guys to sound off down in the comments. Who is the better quarterback? Type KM for Kyler Murray or MS for Matthew Stafford. Mitchell Rentsch from Chat Sports, and coming up here on today's show, we're going to be looking at the NFC wildcard matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the Arizona Cardinals. Two division rivalry games that we've actually have already seen twice this year. The Cardinals, they won the first matchup 37-20. The Rams, they won the second matchup 30-23. But you know what? All those, it doesn't really mean anything at this point. Monday night football, Cardinals up against the Rams. You got Arizona with an 11-6 record up against the Rams with a 12-5 record. Now let's look at the last five games for the Cardinals, because this is kind of a tale of two totally different teams, and I get it. When these two teams played early on in the season, this was a much different football team. And since Arizona has lost their star receiver to DeAndre Hopkins, they've also lost a few other key pieces as well. As you can see, hasn't been all that great. They have lost four out of the last five games, only beating the Dallas Cowboys back in Week 17, and they just gave up 38 points to the Seattle Seahawks. Then you have the Rams side of the football. I really thought that they were going to win their final five games after taking care of business against the Cardinals, Seahawks, Vikings, Ravens, and in one of the most thrilling games, and actually probably one of the reasons why I don't have a voice today, is because that 49ers and Rams game was absolutely electric. I think we can all agree, if Sean McVay wouldn't have ran into the end zone, the 49ers wouldn't have gotten upset, and then it might have been a little bit of a different story. Now, in every single one of these videos, I want you guys to let us know, who do you think's going to win? Do you think it's going to be the 4-seed Rams at home? Well, then guess what? You got to go ahead and type LAR. If you think it's going to be the Arizona Cardinals, they're going to win this game, type ARI. That's going to be the pinned comment on today's show. So when you're getting hit with that YouTube ad break, scroll on down and let us know. Now let's look at the NFC playoff picture here, because, you know, this was a pretty interesting finish to the season. The Green Bay Packers, they're the number one team with a 13-4 record despite losing their final game to the Lions, but let's face it, they didn't play their starters. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the Dallas Cowboys, they won in the final week. The Rams, they lost, so if they would have won that game, they actually would have been the number two seed. You got the Arizona Cardinals, they've definitely had a little bit of an up and down stretch. The 49ers are the sixth. The Philadelphia Eagles are the number seven seed. Now, coming into this one, the Rams are four-point favorites. The over-under is set at 50 points. And remember, the very first game, 37-20, but that Cardinals team is not the same Cardinals team. And then the Rams team that just won this past game against Arizona, 30-23, I think that's a little bit more accurate of what type of game you could potentially see. Now, if you want to go ahead and bet on the Arizona Cardinals to beat the Rams, you can do that. If you want to bet on the Rams to beat the Cardinals, you can do that. If you want to be a guy that bets the under, wouldn't be me. If you want to go ahead and bet the over, you can go ahead and do that at chatsports.com/bet. Promo code NFL Daily is going to get you 125% deposit bonus. Now, let's just say this. Maybe you don't want to bet on this game at all, because betting on divisional rivalry games can be a little bit difficult. You can bet on any other NFL playoff game, or you can also go ahead and put your money where your mouth is in terms of NFC title odds. Packers, right now at plus 175, they have the best odds to win the NFC. Buccaneers, plus 300. Rams at plus 500, despite them being the 4-seed. Cowboys at plus 550. Then you got Arizona, 49ers, and Eagles all the way down there at the bottom with plus 2,800 odds. Where do you have to go ahead and put your money down? Anyone paying attention? Chatsports.com/bet. Promo code NFL Daily. It's the best deal on the internet that I can guarantee you. Go ahead, put some money down. It's going to make the games a little bit more entertaining. All right, let's look at some of these injuries, because there is quite a bit of major injuries, we'll say, in this game for both sides of the football. The major one here that most Ram fans or most football people are going to be monitoring is Jordan Fuller. He injured his ankle in that game up against the 49ers in Week 18. We're still going to try to keep you guys up to date on whether or not he's going to be able to go in this one, but that's definitely the main injury. Sebastian Joseph Day, he ended up injuring himself in the light of day as well, the defensive tackle with the pec injury. And then Robert Rochelle, cornerback, injured his chest. Let's look at the Arizona Cardinals. And I mean, you know, I always have this debate on wondering who's maybe the toughest player in the National Football League. J. J.J. Watt has to be up there. I mean, this guy injured his shoulder. Nobody gave him a chance to come back and play. If you remember, a few years ago, he came back and played for the Houston Texans when nobody thought he was going to be able to. He's got an injured shoulder. He got cleared. I actually think he's going to be able to suit up and go in this one. Another injury to watch, Chase Edmonds. How is he going to be able to impact this game? He was a big-time contributor in the pass for Arizona up against the Rams. Rondell Moore, the rookie wide receiver, he needs to be able to step up because that offense really, really is missing DeAndre Hopkins, Jordan Phillips, and then Marco Wilson. Now, earlier on, I told you, hey, what I want you to do is predict who's going to win. Let's go the next, let's go that extra level, right? Predict the score of Rams-Cardinals over under 50 points, Rams 4-point favorites. So scroll on down in the comment section. Let me know. Give me that score prediction for Rams up against Arizona. Now, every single show that we do, we have to create a goal, right? I don't know what kind of goals that you set at your job. Believe it or not, this is how we make money, and this is how we put a roof over our head. And our goal was to hit 276,000 subscribers. So if we haven't gotten there yet, I might not be able to make any more videos. I don't know. But to help us reach that goal, look underneath every video that we do. Click the subscribe button. And if you could tell your friends, hey, these guys at Chat Sports are interactive. They love sports and, you know, they're halfway decent to hang out with. We would greatly appreciate that. We are a free channel. And to make sure that you never miss any news, any rumors, or all the updates around these games, also turn on those notifications underneath the video. Click the bell. Literally looks like that. And then click all. Now let's turn our conversation to the offensive side of the football. And you're obviously going to talk about both quarterbacks of these teams, like I asked you when I started the video. Who's the better one? Matthew Stafford, 67.2% completion percentage, 4,886 yards, 41 touchdowns, 17 interceptions. You've seen some of the ups and some of the downs of Matthew Stafford, which I can actually say the exact same thing for Kyler Murray. I mean, if you would have asked me halfway through the season, who do you think is the MVP frontrunner? Probably would have said Kyler Murray. But a little bit of a bumpy end to the season. He's got 24 touchdowns, 10 interceptions, 3,787 yards, but also can get it done with his legs, which is something that Matthew Stafford cannot. We also have some more injury updates to be able to kind of break down. Cam Akers was a running back that I drafted in my fantasy league. And unfortunately, before the season even started, he had a torn Achilles, and they were like, all right, he's done for the year. Well, Cam was like, wait a minute. And this rumor started popping up when the Rams went out and traded for Odell Beckham Jr. He's kind of like, all right, well, I might actually be able to come back and help the team perform in the playoffs. He's cleared, activated for this game, and if he's able to go, that's a really awesome story for the running back out of Florida State. Another running back that we're going to talk about here is Sony Michel, who has been doing his best to try to handle the workload. The issue is this. He's not even close to the athlete that Cam Akers is. Michelle just looks like a slow plotter. 208 carries, 845 yards, 4 touchdowns. But then there's this guy, Cooper Kupp. I know a lot of times people bring up names like Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady in the MVP discussion. Heck, Jonathan Taylor was even getting a lot of conversation. Why the hell is Cooper Kupp's name not getting brought up more? This dude's got 145 catches, 1,947 yards, and 16 touchdowns. He leads the NFL in all three of those categories. I don't know, last time I checked, that's pretty darn impressive to me. Now let's talk about some of the Arizona Cardinals players. James Conner, really, really interesting stat line here. 202 carries, 752 yards, 15 rushing touchdowns. He's been an absolute monster in the red zone. Now another player, remember, we mentioned him, Chase Edmonds, banged up a little bit. If both Edmonds and Conner are not 100% healthy, but at least have the ability to be able to go out there and be that lightning and thunder type of running back duo, that's really going to help Arizona out because Edmonds, I've always liked this kid since he's come out of Fordham. He's also got over 40 catches, really good dual threat running back. But when they're able to use Edmonds in the passing game and run the ball between the tackles, and then once we get in the red zone, then you pound the ball with James Conner, that's actually when I really truly believe this offense is at its best. Now, speaking of those offenses, who has the edge? Who has the upper hand? If you think the Rams have the better offense, I want you to type R for Rams. If you believe the Arizona Cardinals have the better offense, then guess what? Go ahead and type C. Now, when you do this video, you got to try to break it down from both sides of the team, both sides of the football for both teams, right? And I was asked, the Rams win this game if they win the turnover battle. I personally believe right now Los Angeles is playing better football than Arizona, and as long as they don't let Kyler Murray and that offense on some shorter fields, as long as Stafford doesn't have some of his really bad turnover games, I believe that they're going to win. Now, for the Arizona Cardinals to win, I've really noticed Murray try to put a little bit too much on his back and carry this offense without DeAndre Hopkins. If you can have a balanced attack, and that's running the football effectively, which then can set up some play action, which then could set up some of those deeper plays that Arizona is really lacking over the last 5 weeks, that's when I think Arizona can win. If they're balanced, they have a shot. So who you got, y'all? Type LAR for the Los Angeles Rams or ARI for the Arizona Cardinals. The more and more I think about this game, I would love for the Cardinals to win. However, I'm going to put my money on Aaron Donald. I'm going to put my money on Jalen Ramsey and on that Rams defense. So I'm going to go ahead and type LAR.